now for more from Moscow with Jose Arnulfo Wick Veloso, the President and CEO of the Philippine National Bank. Good to have you with us, Wick. Welcome to the program.
Hi, Kathy. Good morning from Moscow.
You're right. It's just a little past 10 in the morning there. What brings you to Russia as part of the business delegation traveling with the President?
Philippine National Bank is joining the visit to get a better understanding of the opportunities between Philippines and Russia. Yesterday, we were given the opportunity together with top construction companies in the Philippines to view various infrastructure projects that we can possibly partner with, and PNB is very happy to be able to connect our customers to all of those that can provide the technology. Dr. Lucia Tan wanted us to support the infrastructure program of the government, specifically the build project of President Duterte, as 712 of our branches are majority placed in the provinces. There are a lot of opportunities for us to take advantage of the technology that is being offered here.
So what sort of technology, Wick? I mean, this is really an exciting moment for you. I mean, you're just coming up to a year in office as president and CEO, and there's really been a big push in growing the share of business of the current customers in that space, in the infrastructure build of the government.
Yes, there are a lot of opportunities, specifically in modular technology. There's opportunities for us to review their technology in bridge building. They have a very wonderful bridge here that can highlight both a tourist attraction, having a restaurant in the middle of a bridge, while at the same time having the ability to build a very good infrastructure between two islands. One of the things that also allowed us to get a look into are the various support systems that our airports will need. The cost of navigational technology and security technology to allow us to be able to screen passengers is significantly cheaper as what I was able to observe, and these are things that they can share back to our customers who are involved in the airport and the terminal construction in the Philippines.
Interesting that you make a mention of tourism, because there appears to be a synergistic sort of a plan going there, that there's infrastructure build and tourism, which has a huge multiplier effect. So what sort of growth are you seeing with these kinds of projects, and in which parts of the country are you hoping to invest in?
A lot of our infrastructure needs are in the provinces, and that is where all of the opportunities lie. Also, Russians are also looking for opportunities for us to be able to have more tourist destinations or tourism projects between our two countries. These are things that we would like to be able to work on.
Are you hoping to sign any agreements or memorandum of understanding before you head back to the Philippines with the meetings that you're holding with the Russian businessmen?
We hope so. We are spending the rest of the day and the whole day tomorrow to be able to speak with a lot of the businessmen interested to invest in the Philippines. And we're optimistic that this trip will be very fruitful for both countries.
I understand, Wick, that PNB is joining the meetings together with the Philippine businesses as part of what is called the Safe Aggressive Strategy. What is this about?
Sorry, can you repeat your question?
Yes, part of the Safe Aggressive Strategy. What is that strategy about when you meet with the Russian businesses there, the Philippine delegation in Russia?
It's the Safe Aggressive Growth Strategy that we are embarking on. And that safe, aggressive growth strategy is actually focused in helping the businesses that are scattered across the countryside that will be able to support the Philippine economy. As we continue to have a very good growth opportunity, we are here to be able to help our countrymen be able to have the ability to have the growth opportunity that Manila has experienced, be part of the provinces where the lot more Filipinos that will be able to connect, either via our potential opportunities on infrastructure, food, or manufacturing.
Final point, Wick, as the inflation numbers had come out a couple of hours ago, it's at a more than three-year low. Are you hopeful that the government can still achieve at least 6% GDP for the full year?
Oh, I'm very optimistic that the government is going to achieve a higher growth target. And they have clearly demonstrated that they are able to tame inflation. They are now going to be able to focus on growth.
All right. Well, thank you so much for keeping us up to speed there where you are in Moscow. Safe journey back to Manila. Wick Veloso, President and CEO of Philippine National Bank in Moscow.